Welcome, Mike Martinez, here again sharing some information with you. You know, I love sharing information because one of my biggest responsibilities as a public adjuster is to help educate homeowners and business owners as to what their rights are and what you are eligible for and what you're due. Because a lot of times, if you don't know what you're doing, you don't know what you're eligible for, you won't get it. You have to ask in a very specific way in order to do this. And this article today that I came across, by the way, it's Business Wire. So this is an article that's going to be brought out to other newspapers. Usually the, you know, Associated Press picks this up and puts it in different newspapers. But this company here, Business Wire, actually owned by Berkshire Hathaway. For those investors that are seeing this, you know, Berkshire Hathaway is a Warren Buffett company. Warren Buffett is one of the most successful investors. It's a whole other story. But the story here, or the article here, is about two law firms that are coming together in order to represent several, actually thousands of homeowners in several different states that were either underpaid or denied because of Hurricane Matthew. Hurricane Matthew was something that happened just recently, I think maybe a month or so ago. As you can see over here, December 13th, this is when this was, this article was released, December 13, 2016. And the article was released from Dallas. And it basically says that the two law firms are accepting cases from homeowners, business owners, property managers, condominiums association, and homeowners associations in Florida, South Carolina, Georgia, and neighboring states involved in insurance disputes arising from claims related to Hurricane Matthew. The two firms are combining their efforts in order to help those property damage claims that have either been underpaid or denied entirely. Underpaid or denied entirely. This is something that happens. I don't want to beat a dead horse. But the fact of the matter is, this is something that happens, and it happens routinely. And that's why you need somebody to represent you. Now, here's what I'm going to say. You know, a law firm is great, you know, as a last choice. And here's why I say that. Because lawyers are constantly fighting insurance companies. And they know how to interpret that information, that if you looked at your policy right now, you wouldn't have a clue. I mean, it's very, very, you know, the information, the way it's printed and the way it's stated, most people don't understand that stuff. You need a lawyer to interpret that information, or a public adjuster. But their lawyers are good at interpreting that information and fighting insurance companies and getting your money, right? What I'm going to say is that a public adjuster is just a little bit above that, simply because, not that we're above lawyers, but simply because in this particular case, when homeowners are fighting an insurance company for a specific home insurance claim, the reason why we may be a little bit more adept at working these claims is because we know what type of damages are listed or are eligible for some kind of a return for you, right? So, you know, a lawyer may understand accidents and personal injuries and things like that, but unless they are, you know, working specifically and have a routine of understanding what type of damages homeowners are experiencing, they themselves may not cover everything that needs to be covered. You know, a simple claim for roof shingles coming off the roof, right, can involve a whole lot of things, a whole lot of damages that you're not aware of, and that some lawyers may not be aware of, and that's where a public adjuster would come in. We specialize in knowing that it's not just the three shingles that fell off your roof. It's also the wood that's underneath those shingles, the sheeting that's underneath that, the water that dripped into the attic that now damaged some of the insulation in the attic, right? The water that went and dripped into the ceiling and went and corroded the ceiling, and now that created damage. So there's a lot of different things that go on with one simple claim, right? And a public adjuster, again, we specialize in knowing what are all the things that need to be replaced and need to be brought back to pre-damage condition. That's a very important statement in the claims process that you want to be aware of, and your whoever is representing you wants to be aware of, right? And there's a lot of intricate things there that may or may not be, covered. And as public adjusters, we know what it is that we need to do in order to do that. So, again, bringing this information to you just to kind of open the eyes. In my last video, which is, my last video was Like a Good Neighbor, right? You can look that up on my YouTube channel. But Like a Good Neighbor was talking about some things that were happening with State Farm, which, weren't handled properly. I'll use that term for lack of better words, right? But these things happen all the time, and if you're not being represented, you're going to miss out. That's the bottom line. So what I'm saying is, hopefully you'll never need my services, but if you do need my services, if you have a claim that you are considering, or if you had a claim over the last 12 months and you need to verify whether you were paid properly, or again, if you're starting a claim now and you want to maximize what you're going to get the first time around, I encourage you, pick up the phone, give me a call. What this article was saying here is that some people were underpaid and some people were denied entirely. And the reason is, and I want you to keep this in mind, because the reason is that a lot of times, right, you pick up the phone and you say, hey, yeah, my name is Mike Martinez from XYZ address, and here's my policy number, right? And you're talking to that great customer service guy. Now, let me say something. That great customer service guy is not a minimum wage worker. That's a guy that's been trained, highly trained, to ask you specific questions. And as you're talking, he's looking at your computer screen, right? He's looking at his computer screen, and he's looking at your policy. And he's asking you questions that may or may not be to your best interest. How do you answer those things? You may not know to answer those things properly. Hey, did you by any chance see those shingles shaking any time in the last 6 months? Were they, did you see any of them loose? Have any of them fallen off? Now, how you answer those questions, right? And hey, I'm a good guy. Hey, I'm going to take care of you. By the way, did you see any of those shingles loose over the last 3 months? Right? How you answer that question can determine whether you're going to be denied or whether the claim is going to go through. Very, very important. What we say, if you hire me as your public adjuster, first of all, no out-of-pocket cost to do this, right? But if you hire me as a public adjuster, I'm going to say, from this moment on, let us take care of it, okay? You don't have to talk to the insurance company at all. As a matter of fact, we tell you, don't ever talk to the insurance company, because they may ask you some questions that may derail your claim. So, as you can see here, underpaid or denied entirely. Underpaid or denied entirely. This is a hurricane. Most hurricanes are covered because it's a wind damage. That wind is a peril that is covered under most policies, right? But if you're asked that question and you answer the question the wrong way, or you answer it without really guessing, you know, you're guessing some answers, right? Because you don't really even know. Or maybe I'm steering the conversation to get you to answer in a certain way. Trust me, these things happen. This is how you get denied claims. So what I'm saying is, let us handle that. Don't fall in that trap of thinking, hey, these guys are 100% behind me. Listen, the fact of the matter is, insurance companies make their profit by collecting premiums, not by paying out claims. They try to minimize paying out claims. That's how, when you see them standing in the stock market clapping their hands saying they got $1 billion in profit, that wasn't because they paid out as much claims as they could, right? They didn't maximize what you were supposed to get back. They minimized what you were supposed to get back. You need somebody on your side. That's who I am. My name is Mike Martinez. I'm a public adjuster. I'm here to serve your needs if and when you need me. Hopefully you'll never need me, but if you do need me, I'm here to serve. All right? So pick up the phone. It doesn't cost anything to find out whether you have a viable claim or not, right? That's the bottom line. Whether you have a viable claim or not, there's no out-of-pocket cost for me to go to your house and see your policy and see whether you have something that you can claim, right? Or whether it's going to be profitable enough for you to claim, right? I will, you know, decipher all that information, put it in, and explain it to you so that you can ultimately make a very educated decision. And that's what we do, all right? So, Mike Martinez, my number is on the screen. Hopefully you'll never need me, but if you do need me, I am here to work on your behalf. Speak to you soon.